terms of the GPS diary, I mean, I was kind of, at the time I was kind of interested to make work about, reflect upon, you know, what an artist does and where does daily life stop and where does, you know, the art begin. At the same time, I always like to use technology or like to use or misuse technology. So I was quite curious about them when I heard about the GPS units. So I just started to use one to record my daily movements, first just for a week and for a month, and eventually I thought I have to do like a whole year. In GPS Miro, I mean, I was really kind of curious how I could, on the one hand, use the GPS unit and kind of take, you know, reference to the city of Palma and the architectural shape of roads and other areas or parks. And the same moment when I looked at the sketchbooks of Miro, like the Catalan sketchbooks, mm-hmm. and I was particularly interested in this he did in Palma. So I was trying just to find a way how I could relate these sketches he did with how I could move around in the city. The Dragonera project. I was just thinking about how could I work with this GPS idea and transfer to particular geographically areas. And so I was really looking, and islands seemed like a perfect geographically identity because of the shape they have, and people, you know the shapes. And in terms of Dragonera, there was also the added layer of that is a natural park. The idea was to spend 5-6 days on the actual island in its natural surroundings and cover as many areas as possible in that time. What I quite liked about the, in particular about the Dragonera project, was this relationship between the outcome, which is very synthetic, very pure, very like data diagram-like, but in the same moment you have this really kind of analog experience.
The eBay landscape basically it has the form of a very classic and simple Japanese moon-like landscape. It's very, you know, relaxing and simple aesthetics, nothing complicated or just super new. But the elements composing the picture are all these elements are you know, live objects, ever changing. For example, the bamboo trees are taken live from CNN.com, so they change as many times as CNN.com updates its website with breaking news. While the mountains, the blue strip, comes from the eBay.com stock market chart. Each star represents an online users. So this landscape is even a live environment where people can meet in some ways and share this online experience. eBay Landscape, that is a project done in 2004, was completed by paintings and prints and an archive and then the online ever-changing version. So even there is this contradiction between, you know, a physical painting and the ephemeral nature of these ever-changing landscapes, and I like to establish a dialogue between them so that people can try to interact with the painting and contemplate the online work, so exchanging experiences that usually are not, you know, part of the medium itself.
Allora, l'idea del paesaggio nasce insieme all'idea del ritratto, nel voler realizzare una pittura con un mezzo digitale, ispirandosi ai temi e ai generi classici della pittura. E per il paesaggio io ho scelto di lavorare su due temi principali. Il primo tema sono i debug landscape, cioè un parallelo tra l'errore informatico e il sistema ecologico sulla Terra. Il secondo genere di paesaggi invece è spinta alla costruzione di un'estetica legata al mondo dei videogiochi, e sono i solid landscape, dove frequentando i videogiochi, all'interno dei videogiochi, frequentando non per giocare ma per vedere gli ambienti, i paesaggi, ho realizzato delle pitture ispirate a questi, come un pittore paesaggista, nello stesso modo, cambiando però il punto di prospettiva, che non è più la realtà fisica ma la realtà poligonale. La prima serie invece poi di paesaggi che ho realizzato si chiamavano Promotional Landscape ed invece sono ispirati ai quartieri generali delle maggiori aziende che sono state protagoniste della fase della New Economy. E queste pitture flat sono invece molto sintetiche, però comunque rappresentano un concetto molto presente, reale, contemporaneo, per cui è un mix di un mio sentimento di bellezza e un ragionamento sulla pittura oggi contemporanea.
Legible nature specifically came out of a boyhood desire of growing up in Hawaii and seeing birds fly around and always feeling like they could be conveying messages or might be conveying messages if only if it were a way that we could interpret those or read those. And so this piece, the birds are slowly spelling out messages. They fly around very naturally and then periodically they converge to form letters, but just for a split second, and it's always beyond our grasp of understanding, beyond our ability to completely resolve the messages, but we should know that they're there, or that should be the feeling that's conveyed. The legible nature is all written in code and generated by the computers, that it's very important to me that things, just as in nature, things look familiar, like we know when a leaf falls what a leaf falling looks like, but it never falls the same way twice. It's always new, and capturing that aspect was really important.